Boy, it is sweltering out there. Very hot, very humid. That's going to continue through tomorrow before we begin to see a transition on Sunday with increased rain late in the day as a cool front tries to come through and we begin to get a little bit of that tropical moisture from Fred. Then we'll really have some impacts from Fred by the early part of next week, and most of those impacts as of right now looks to be rainfall. Will there be flooding? Well, there's still a chance for that, yes. If it trends more toward the west, then we're going to come down on this a little bit. If it trends more toward the east, then this would go up from medium to high. So I'm going to keep it in that moderate risk right now. Not expecting a lot of wind out of this. It might be breezy at times, but as far as high or strong winds, that is not a threat right now, and neither is that level of severe weather. We'll continue to track it, though, but let's get you caught up. Tropical Depression Fred, look at this. You can finally see a little bit of a low pressure area, but the real energy has detached. It's actually south. This thing is now interacting more on land, so it's amazing, quite honestly, that it has lasted this long, but I think being over water for the last 24 hours has helped that. Still, the wind sustained at 35 miles per hour, so hasn't seen any strengthening at all, but still could, as it is expected to move back over water, where it will likely or could become a tropical storm again later today. Now, the path is pretty much the same as it has been. Not as lot has changed between, say, basically Cuba and the peninsula of Florida. What has changed is its track is trending more out toward the west, and the system itself is weakening faster once it's on land. So looking like it's going to make landfall Monday somewhere around Tallahassee, Florida. And then you see as we get into Tuesday and Wednesday, look at this, rides up through Alabama and then possibly right into Nashville as a pretty strong area of low pressure, but not necessarily still a tropical depression. So what does that mean? That means we're on the east side of it. That means we will get quite a bit of rainfall. But if it trends out more toward the west, even more than this, then we're starting to lose some of those rain totals and rainfall amounts. Let me show you. As we take a look at some of these weather models, you can see more and more that is the trend pulling it away from us and out into western Tennessee. What's next is this post-tropical cyclone 7. This is a very strong system that we have been tracking for the past few days. Winds right now are the same as Fred, but it's moving faster to the west at 21 miles per hour, looking like it wants to follow a very similar path to Fred. And look at this. We're talking about getting impacts from Fred now, next Tuesday and Wednesday. By then, this could be Tropical Storm Grace. In fact, it likely will be named that this weekend. And Grace could be where Fred is right now. Just crazy. It's definitely active out there. All right, let's take a look. One weather model. This is the European model. This actually brings it right overhead, but it slowed down a little bit. So as we take a look at the timing, Sunday night, I think we're going to have an intense chance for rain. We've got a cool front that's going to try to come through. That's going to interact with some of this moisture coming in from the Gulf, and our rain chances will increase as we go into late Sunday. Then here comes Monday. I think we're going to have some waves of rain coming off of this system, and if this model is correct, then it would be basically Tuesday morning. We'd have a lot of rainfall, but the core would still be back in Atlanta. It would be Tuesday later in the day into Wednesday before it makes its way across the upstate and the mountains, dumping quite a bit of rain. And then we'd be on the backside pretty quickly, and then we get back to scattered showers. If this model's correct, between Sunday and Monday, we'd have half an inch to an inch of rain on average. And then Tuesday, my goodness, we'd have up to 6, maybe 7 inches of rain. Personally, I think this model is overdoing it. I do think it's going to trend more westward, which might be more in line with the GFS. Now, GFS has a very weak system, barely alive by the time it makes landfall. But look at this, between Sunday and Monday, still about half an inch to an inch of rain. And then by Tuesday, we're looking at more like 1 to maybe 3 inches of rain. Now, that's good. We need rain, and I think this is probably closer to what we can expect. But again, we continue to tweak this as changes come in. And the reason it's kind of still wobbly out there is because that system, Fred, really doesn't have its legs yet. It's still trying to survive a hit along Hispaniola from earlier this week, and it's half in the water, half on land right now. So as it strengthens, this will be fine-tuned. Outside right now, we've got some pop-up showers and isolated thunderstorms. They will not be as widespread today as they have been in the past, but still expect some lightning, some downpours as we go throughout this afternoon and tonight as well. That's what you get when you have high heat and high humidity. Again, that continues for tomorrow as well. And then getting into the end of the weekend and early next week, our rain chances go up Monday, Tuesday, possibly Wednesday, but we'll see. In the meantime, notice temperatures. It'll be a little cooler because of that rainfall, but we're still going to have a lot of tropical moisture in the air.